Hey everyone, this is Patrice with the Positivity Corner, and I'm back with yet another video. And this is actually going to be the last one I think that I'm going to do right now for my brief, very brief tribute to the late Stephen Sondheim, who we just lost recently. I just wanted to play a couple of his well-known tunes. A giant, absolute giant of musical theater. This play right here, ooh, this is one of his most popular works. It came out in 1979, folks. I'm just going to give you the title. Sweeney Todd, the Demon Barber of Fleet Street. Ooh, if you like your horror movies, you will love this play. And you're saying, what? It's a musical? Yeah. And it's actually based on a character that was developed during Victorian era England in the 1840s. A character named Sweeney Todd emerged. In order to entertain themselves during the Victorian era, people wrote a lot and printed these little pamphlets called penny dreadfuls. And it was kind of like, you know, not a comic book, because it didn't have pictures in it per se, although some of them were illustrated. But it told stories. And Sweeney Todd, the Demon Barber, wasn't a real person, but sure sounded like it. And he was really, really popular as a character during that era. This play that Stephen Sondheim wrote the music and lyrics for is actually based on a drama called Sweeney Todd that came out 6 years earlier in 1973. Now, I'm going to give you a really truncated version of the story, because it gets a little complicated at points. But basically, Sweeney Todd is a barber. And during the period of time that he was a barber, he used a straight razor. He had some mental health issues, and he was basically slitting the throats of his customers and putting them down in the basement. A serial killer. Yeah, but it gets worse. He gets into a relationship sort of with a woman named Mrs. Lovett, who runs a pie shop in the area. All I want to say is that the recipes for the pie meat changed. Ew. You get it. Ew. But let me tell you, the music for this is fabulous. The public ate it up. Why? Because 80%+ of this musical is sung. It's not that much dialogue. And the dialogue that they have, this song is an example, is, you know, there's a snippet of dialogue, but then there's song, like lots of song. Sometimes the music goes on top of the dialogue, and you hear the dialogue, but you hear people singing too at the same time. It's very musical. The night it premiered, allegedly, a famous critic cornered the former director of the Metropolitan Opera House and said, "Why didn't you," meaning the Met, "debut this? It has been called one of the greatest operas or operettas of the latter half of the 20th century. And it has been performed at opera houses all over this world." Yeah. It's a great play. There is actually a filmed version of the play that was on TV. I believe it was on public television or something. Won a ton of awards. It's been made into a movie with Johnny Depp and Helena Bonham Carter. It's brilliant. It's really brilliant. This song that I'm about to play, I'm going to set it up for you. Mrs. Lovett, of course, is running her pie shop, and she's getting real busy because of the meat situation. Ew. Anyway, she hires an assistant named Tobias. And Tobias has had a rough start, and he kind of looks up to her as sort of like a mom, you know, or an auntie, you know. And he's just very fond of her. There's some plot points advancing, and he decides that he's gonna protect her because he cares about her. And that's what this song basically talks about. The fabulous Angela Lansbury played and originated Mrs. Lovett on Broadway. Lynn Cario, another great Broadway figure. He originated Sweeney Todd. Tobias, who sings this song, is Ken Jennings. And also Angela Lansbury contributes dialogue and singing as well for this one. This is 1979. Sweeney Todd. And this beautiful song is called Not While I'm Around.
You know, Mum, there's nothing I wouldn't do for you. If there was a monster, an ogre, or anything bad like that, what was after you, I'd rip it apart with my bare fists, I would.
What a sweet child it is.
Even if it was just a man.
A man, dear?
A man. What was bad, and what might be luring you, all unbeknownst, into his evil deeds like.
Here, what is this? What are you talking about?
Nothing's gonna harm you, not while I'm around. Nothing's gonna harm you, no, sir, not while I'm around. Demons are prowling everywhere nowadays. I'll send them howling, I don't care, I got ways.
Of course you do. What a sweet, affectionate child it is.
No one's gonna hurt you, no one's gonna dare. Others can desert you, not to worry, whistle, I'll be there. Demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing can harm you, not while I'm around. Not to worry, not to worry, I may not be smart, but I ain't dumb. I can do it, put me to it, show me something I can overcome. Not to worry, Mum. Being close and being clever ain't like being true. I don't need to, I won't never hide a thing from you. Like some.
Now let's stop all this foolish chatter and just sit here nice and quiet. Nothing's gonna harm you, not while I'm around. Nothing's gonna harm you, Toby, not while I'm around.
Demons are prowling everywhere nowadays. I don't care.
Boys and their fancies, what will we think of next?
No one's gonna hurt you, no one's gonna dare. Others can desert you, not to worry, we'll still all be there. Demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing's gonna harm you. Not while I'm around.
Oh, that's great. I love that. Oh my goodness, that's from 1979. The musical Sweeney Todd, The Demon Barber of Fleet Street. And that was sung beautifully by Ken Jennings with an assist from Angela Lansbury. And it's called Not While I'm Around. Let me tell you, Stephen Sondheim, oh boy, I don't even know what to say about him. He's so influential, changed the game for American musical theater and musical theater in general. May he rest in eternal peace. Thank you, Stephen Sondheim, for your unique, once in a lifetime gift. I don't think there would be anybody else like him in my lifetime, certainly. I would hope that young people would take up the mantle and write for musical theater. That's about all I could say. If anybody has any comments, please comment with your favorite Stephen Sondheim songs, or if you've seen any of the plays, your experiences. I'd just love to hear about them. I, of course, missed a bunch of his plays, including Into the Woods, Assassins, Sunday in the Park with George. I just wanted to play a few of his tunes in honor of his work and his huge legacy in the musical theater world. As always, this is Patrice with the Positivity Corner. Please like, click, share, subscribe for the content. And I will be back with my regular format with my favorite artists, favorite songs, and videos. And, of course, much more music for you to enjoy. Take care, everybody.